This work is the work of truth seeking. The real seeking the real. It is all music, speech, action, and attention, pointing to the source of all music, speech, action, and attention. This work overflows with radiant blossoms, nourishing fruits, and viable seeds. It is all uniquely personal, profoundly impersonal, and wholly free from distinctions of any sort. This work is all at once the mirror, the reflection, and the reflected. When I say this work, I mean all in one word, all of this. I mean the one great work of self-discovery, purification, and realization. I mean this 8-hour collection of sounds and silences. And I mean all the efforts needed to bring blossom, fruit, and seed. From seed. The ground must be cleared, manured, watered, and tended. Also, of course, there is the sun. The clearing, manuring, watering, and tending, not to mention you and I, are all instruments of that sun. This work is not background music, but as it works and your attention shifts, it will be. What matters is the attention. When you realize that this is your teacher teaching you, ripening will occur. There is no such state as seeing the real. Who is to see what? You can only be the real, which you are anyhow. Thank you.
The problem is only mental. Abandon false ideas, that is all. There is no need of true ideas. There aren't any. I am not just saying what I'm saying, and I'm not saying just what I'm saying. If you are not just hearing what you're hearing, and if you're not hearing just what you're hearing, then Rumi's saying may come just close enough to saying something that just cannot be said. Everything here has a double meaning. Only when you open both eyes at once does the world have depth. With only one eye, the world is nothing but a surface. Are spoken, there is silence. When the relative is over, the absolute remains. The silence before the words were spoken, is it different from the silence that comes after? The silence is one, and without it, the words could not have been heard. It is always there at the back of the words. Shift your attention from words to silence, and you will hear it. Someone said, "There is no dervish." Or if there is a dervish, that dervish is not there. Look at a candle flame in bright noon sunlight. If you put cotton next to it, the cotton will burn, but its light has become completely mixed with the sun. That candle light you can't find is what's left of a dervish.
Now the tellest good tidings to Zion,
If you sprinkle 1 ounce of vinegar over 200 tons of sugar, no one will ever taste the vinegar. Deer faints in the paws of a lion. The deer becomes another glazed expression on the face of the lion. These are rough metaphors for what happens to the lover. There's no one more openly irreverent than a lover. He or she jumps up on the scale opposite eternity and claims to balance it. And no one more secretly reverent. A grammar lesson. The lover died. Lover is subject and agent, but that can't be. The lover is defunct. Only grammatically is the dervish lover a doer. In reality, with he or she so overcome, so dissolved into love, all qualities of doingness disappear. Your grief for what you've lost lifts a mirror up to where you're bravely working. Expecting the worst, you look, and instead, here's the joyful face you've been wanting to see. Your hand opens and closes, and opens and closes. If it were always a fist, or always stretched open, you would be paralyzed. Your deepest presence is in every small contracting and expanding, the two as beautifully balanced and coordinated as bird wings. Muhammad says, "I come before dawn to chain you and drag you off." It's amazing and funny that you have to be pulled away from being tortured, pulled out into this spring garden, but that's the way it is. Almost everyone must be bound and dragged here. Only a few come on their own. Children have to be made to go to school at first. Then some of them begin to like it. They run to school. They expand with the learning. Later, they receive money because of something they've learned at school, and they get really excited. They stay up all night, as watchful and alive as thieves. Remember the rewards you get for being obedient. There are two types on the path. Those who come against their will, the blindly religious people, and those who obey out of love. The former have ulterior motives. They want the midwife near because she gives them milk. The others love the beauty of the nurse. The former memorize the proof texts of conformity and repeat them. The latter disappear into whatever draws them to God. Both are drawn from the source.